Oh my gosh, I got cut off. So this is part two of my video right now. I'm making it. I'm having to record it again. And oh my gosh, this is actually like the fourth time I'm trying to record this today. But actually, the first part right now actually saved on my phone. So I'm going to upload that. And then this is the part two. So I was just getting into my dream. So I was saying that I had a dream, or I had visions last night. I'm sorry, not a dream. I had these visions last night as I was closing my eyes, but I was still awake. I had these visions last night. Today is Wednesday, April 18th, 2018. And I feel like this is an urgent warning because I'm starting to feel the anxiety again that I was mentioning. I'm starting to feel that again now. But anyways, I was having these these visions. So in the vision, America was being attacked, and I knew that it was imminent. Imminent meaning that from when I dreamed it, from when I seen it last night in the vision, that it's happening imminently. And it was like all, I just felt like the whole world's focus right now is on Israel, Syria, Iran, the Middle East. And I think that Russia's going to come out of nowhere. They've been quiet all week. They're going to come out of nowhere and attack us. And I do feel in my spirit that it's going to be during the day. Even though last night in the middle of the night, I felt like something was going to happen and that I should just stay awake. And so I was trying to stay up all night, or not all night, but I was trying to stay up as long as I could. And then so as I finally was laying down, 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning, I had these visions. So anyways, America, all of a sudden, like out of nowhere, and I'm pretty sure it was in my dream, it was daytime, that they're out of nowhere, it was bombs everywhere. Just like all kinds of bombs out of nowhere. And before, I have had a dream before, I think it was about a month ago. And I made a video about it, about missiles, that I was like in a city somewhere walking around outside during the day and a whole bunch of missiles started, dropping and hitting the ground. But they were like ballistic missiles and there was a whole bunch of them. Well, this was different. This dream, this time, were just, they were like bombs, more like explosions. And there was a whole bunch of them. So I don't know if they were nukes or what, but they were like huge, big bombs, like with like big mushroom clouds and like taking out like whole cities and things. And it was weird. Like, I felt like I was there. But I wasn't like on the street level per se, like I was in the last dream, like an actual like, person view or like from myself view. It was more like I was seeing it through a screen, but I was like there though. It's hard to explain. So then, but anyways, there was all kinds of bombs going off and, let me just see what I wrote down here, a little notes about, and there was like bullets in the sky. And just a whole bunch of bombs. And like I said, I don't remember a bunch of the details now because I did not get up and write it down like I should have last night. And I felt like I was almost like in a trance too. Like when I was felt like, okay, I knew I was like telling myself I should get up and write this down. I need to write this down. But then it's almost like, even though I didn't want to, because I felt like I needed to see everything that I was being shown. Also at the same time, it's like, I feel like, I don't know if I even could. I was like in like this trance of just like in this vision. It was crazy. So then anyways, I just feel like this is like a really urgent warning that I need to get out, because today is April 18th and we all know, it's like, Israel's 70th anniversary, party starts today. Their celebration. And I wanted to mention a couple of things. Oh, and there was men on horses. I remember seeing men on horses, like in as far as like, in like army, like with metal, or arm, like with armor on. Okay. And then, and lots of fire. So like the bombs and fire and stuff. Okay. And one other thing I wanted to write or mention that I wrote down, is okay. So last night I was going to make a video yesterday, evening after I seen on the news that this is what really, like, I was like, whoa, first thought of 1 Thessalonians 5:3 when it says, for when they shall say peace and safety comes sudden destruction. And it just like blew me away because on the news last night, on the mainstream news, which is, again, this is the narrative that they're pushing, that they want Americans to believe. There was two stories about peace and safety. North Korea and South Korea were doing peace talks about ending the Korean War, and so they were talking about it. So that was all over the news last night about possible peace deals, or you know, ending the Korean War after I think it was like 65 years or something. I think it was something huge, and so it was. I mean, crazy. That's wild to me. Like after like 65 years or something, peace talks between North Korea and South Korea. And so that was on the mainstream news last night. And then lo and behold, who would have known? I had no idea. Trump was in Mar-a-Lago yesterday in Florida, with the Japanese prime minister. And, I think it was November, December or something when Trump went over there, went to Japan. But anyways, so now he's over here and at Mar-a-Lago. They're supposed to be golfing today together, going golfing. And they showed on the news, them talking, and Trump gave, you know, a little speech to the press. And Trump said peace in his talk. He mentioned peace twice and the word security even. Peace twice and the word security. I'm talking about Japan and how they're basically all buddy buddies now, and how Japan just bought a bunch of goods from the United States, and they're great for trading and, you know, trade and the economy and so forth. And just like how now basically peace talks, and just like now how they're buddies. And so when I heard both of those two peace talk stories yesterday, and then how Trump mentioned security, it just blew me away. And the first thing I thought of was obviously 1 Thessalonians 5:3, when it says, for when they cry peace and safety, comes sudden destruction. So anyways, and also Trump kept saying like, oh, calling Mar-a-Lago the Southern White House. This is the new White House. This is the place to be. Everyone wants to be here. He says all the world leaders want to be at Mar-a-Lago. He says, or go there, I guess, when they come. So anyways, it was just wild. But I'm going to try to upload this before I get stopped again. Praise Jesus, praise Jesus, praise Jesus. Look up our redemption draw tonight. This is so exciting. Oh, also, brothers and sisters, I know how, you know, like there's like the Today in History, and I think Steve Fletcher even did a video of Today in History, April 18th. But I'm not sure if this is on there or not. But instead, like when you Google things about the date, April 18th, well, the other day I Googled Russian holidays, and I like in April, and I was looking, well, April 18th is like Russia War Day or something they call it, I think is what it's called. And basically it's like, it's a special day in Russian war history. There's a story to it about an old leader. And it's been a few days since I read it now, so forgive me. It's been like 3 or 4 days since I looked at it. But basically, it's a huge like Russian war celebration day. Today is. And so with all of these factors, I mean, with the Israel celebration, the fact that Iran said they were going to destroy Israel today, I mean, it's just wild. But again, I think that the whole world's focused on Israel right now. And so I think it's perfect in a sense, like as far as strategic for Russia, that they, you know, now they've been quiet all week, come up out of nowhere and make their strike. And I just pray the blood of Jesus over everybody, Lord, Father, God. And I pray that if you're watching this right now, that you repent, and plead to God that you are counted worthy to escape the wrath coming upon this earth. We love you, Jesus. And again, I pray the blood of Jesus over all of you. And I pray for the lost, and I pray for everybody. Please tell everybody, you know, all right. God bless you.